For the first time, we're getting a glimpse of last month's plane crash off of Molokai through the eyes of one of the survivors. Tonight, he's breaking his silence and sharing photos he snapped during the terrifying ordeal. Breanne Randall sat down with him for an interview you'll see only on KHON2. Breanne?
Joe, Eva Beach resident Ferdinand Puentes captured it all on camera, from the moment the plane hit the water to his fight to stay afloat.
It just hurts, I guess, yeah.
Ferdinand Puentes is still filled with raw emotion almost 1 month after surviving a plane crash.
As the sirens and bells of the airplane was going, it was quiet. Everyone knew what was pretty much going on.
Puentes turned on his GoPro camera moments after the engine of the Makanikai Air Cessna he was on quit, just offshore of Kalaupapa on Molokai.
Seeing the water coming up really fast, and this was pretty much the splashdown when we hit the water.
Puentes and the rest of the passengers jumped out of the sinking plane.
It just bit into me already. Am I dreaming?
He held on to one wing as long as he could. From his vantage point, he got this eerie image of the plane underwater. Despite being an avid waterman, Puentes' life vest wasn't enough to keep him from going under. So pilot Clyde Kawasaki gave him an extra seat cushion to stay afloat.
My steel-toe boots, my heavy work jeans, and my long-sleeve shirt. So, yeah, it was pretty hard and exhausting trying to swim with all that.
After floating for what seemed like hours, Puentes and the rest of the people on board were picked up by the Coast Guard. He was flown to the Queens Medical Center to get checked out.
Could have died. Just, there's so much variations that could have happened. Could have happened for the worse.
Puentes says his life has been forever changed by that day.
A lot of things seems petty now, I guess. Can't take things for granted.
Yesterday, he boarded another round-trip flight to Kalaupapa to overcome his fear of flying.
It hurts, but you have to heal. So it's my way of healing. I have to move forward.
Puentes says he has made a lifelong friend following the ordeal. He and pilot Clyde Kawasaki chat and text to keep up with each other's lives. Now the NTSB continues to investigate what caused the engine to lose power. Breanne Randall, KHON 2 News.